Hope you people are doing well. Okay, today we are going to see our next poetry, Bells for John Whiteside's Daughter. Bells for John Whiteside's Daughter, written by John Crow Ransom. Okay, we will revise this poetry again. Okay, girls, here the poetical lines. There was such speed in her little body and such lightness in her footfall. It is no wonder that her brown study astonishes us all. Her words were rooted in our high window. We looked among orchard trees and beyond. Where she took arms against her shadow or hurried unto the pond. The lazy geese, like a snow cloud, dripping their snow on the green grass, tricking and stopping, sleepy and proud, who cried in goose, alas. For the tireless heart within the little lady withdrawal that made them rise from their noon apple dreams and skittle goose fashion under the skies. But now go the bells and we are ready. In one house we are sternly stopped to say we are vexed at her brown study. Lying so primely propped. Now we'll see the introduction about the author. Introduction of the author. There is John Crow Ransom, 1888 to 1974, was an American who lived in Tennessee. Tennessee is a place. Okay, was a American writer, American poet. Okay. He was called a Southern poet. The poem Bells for John Whiteside's Daughter. Okay, this poem was published in the year 1924. It was published in Ransom's collection of poetry. Okay, it is not a single poetry, it is published in the collection of poetry. That collected poetry name, that is the book name, is Chills and Fever. Chills and Fever. In that collection book, one poem is Bells for John Whiteside's Daughter. Is that clear? This poem depicts a tragic situation in an unsentimental way. This poem depicts a tragic situation in an unsentimental way. Okay, it is supposed that Ransom wrote this poem for one of his acquaintances. We can say like friends are neighbors, or those who are living with. Okay, maybe his colleague or a neighbor named John Whiteside. Okay, maybe we can say his neighbor whose name is John Whiteside. Okay, who lost his daughter at an early stage. Who lost his daughter at an early stage. That is, we can say it is an elegy. Okay. By this poem, Ransom depicts how to mourn a death in an unsentimental way. For him, death is sorrowful one. But if the losers, the parents, imagine the cheerful life of the dead, they can see their dead son or daughter alive in their mind. The young one will be no more dead. Now, what he is telling is, what he wants to convey is, one, that is the parents who has lost their child, whether their son or their daughter, if they think that about their presence, okay, their daughter are alive, they can imagine that cheerful thing what they have done. If they think means that sorrowful thing will become pleasant and they were no more dead. Is that clear, girls? Can you get me? Okay. We'll see the theme of the poem. The theme is a short funeral poem in 5 stanzas. It's a very short poem in 5 stanzas. The theme of the poem is that young girl, probably younger than 10 years old, dies suddenly. You see, she's young, probably like 10 years or below that. Okay, who dies suddenly? Her name and accurate age is not revealed in the poem. Okay, here he mentioned as John Whiteside's daughter instead of mentioning the name. Okay, so it is not mentioned here. The cause of the girl's death is also not revealed. Why she was dead, that also it is not mentioned here. But this is not important to the sense of the poem. The father remembers the playfulness and high spirit of the girl at play. Now, in this poem, he says that the father remembers the high spirit when she used to play. Okay, the girl at play. The vivid imagination, clear imagination, offers a sort of solace. On the other hand, the acquaintances and relatives mourn and vent their anger on death who touched the young girl by his icy fingers. The poet suggests that instead of mourning sorrowfully, if the losers mourn by their vivid imagination, in which getting the pictures of the playful girl, they can make the girl be alive in their mind forever. Instead of thinking about the loss, okay, if they think about the pleasant thing what she has done in during the time, the young girl is not dead, she can be alive in their mind forever. Is that clear, ma? Can you get me? Okay, then we'll see the detailed summary of the poem. Stanza 1, The Astonishing Girl. When the poem begins, there is a corpse of a young girl. The mourner is shocked at the fact of the sudden death. They are astonished, they are very surprised, they are shocked because the fact of the death of sudden death of the little girl. The mourner evidently seems to be the father of the girl. He looks at the dead body of his daughter. The mourner contrasts the young girl with her constant movement in life, with her stillness in death. The girl used to be actively occupied in her work, such as reading, but now she is motionless. That is, she is not able to move. She is still. She is dead, pale and still. The observers, together with the parents, believe that the girl is in her work and not in death. So she will come back to life again as soon as she completes her work. So the father believes that she, the dead girl, is in her brown study, referring to daydream of the girl. It also refers to the dull color of brown, which is symbolically of bare earth and dead leaves. Is that clear, ma? Can you get me? Okay. Then stanza 2, 3 and 4. The high spirit of the girl is explained here. That is, the mourner, that is those who are mourning, those who are expressing their grief, okay, sorrow, commemorates the playfulness of high spirit of the girl. They are discussing how alive she was, okay, how much high spirit she was having. Okay, who is dead now? The girl used to see and hear from window while he was about to begin his work. That picture comes to the mourner and he still believes that the girl is around the window. He sees the picture of the girl who after death seems to take her arms against her shadow and chase the geese as if they were an army to be conquered, to be won. This fantasy seems to tell the readers that she was only one child to the mourner and she employed her vivid imagination to find games of her own. But seeing the girl at play, he too enjoys the game and becomes part of the game. He magically adds the human quality to the geese and says that the geese speak to the girl, who uses a mere stick to chase them. The stick seems to be a magic wand. Here it is about the routine of a little girl, what she was doing before death. Okay, she used to play in the garden, she used to be in the field, and she used to chase her shadow, and she used to raise the geese, that is lazy geese, and she wants to conquer them she used to take a mere stick and chase them. Okay, that stick is seems to be a magic wand. The mourner associates the geese with a snow cloud. This is a contrast to the brown study. Okay, brown and white. The calves of the young girl. The geese cry in the chasing, and he imagines as if they are crying, shedding tears. Can you get me points, girls? Can you? Okay, then poet as an unsentimental father. In this stanza, Ransom projects himself as an unsentimental father who never laments, shows sorrow, sadness or grief, the death or the loss of the girl's life. Ransom suggests that the girl is dead, but he takes it as the girl is a happy, cheerful child who is lost in play in a world of her own. For a grief-stricken parent, the remembrance of the girl's cheerful day offers a sort of solace. They become bearable with the reality. However, the poet brings out the darker element in this situation. The girl has been at war with her shadow, but the shadow has won. So the geese cried for the tireless heart within the little lady. The heart has now tired and stopped. Is that clear, ma? Okay. Now, the fifth stanza, significance of the bell, that is, the cheerful bell goes on to ring. The mourner understands that they are ready to bury. Okay, that is, the final call has come. The brown study, the corpse of the girl, is rightly placed in her coffin. The acquaintances are sorrowful and vexed to see the body of the girl. They are engrossed in anxiety that the young girl has ended her life so soon. Their anxiety turns into anger and they lament, and they show their grief, extreme grief, we can say. Agony. But for the mourner, the bell interrupts the world of fairy tale and imagination. The bell lets the mourner realize the dark fact that the girl is dead. The poet is insignificant to the sound of the bell, which is usually given for a funeral, that is, the last call. He believes that bells can be for either mourning or celebration. For the poet, the present bell sound can help the mourner to remember and recall his happy, cheerful daughter. The poet suggests that if the grief is strike and enter into the imaginary world, where they can see their beloved one's playfulness and high spirit, the dead daughter will be alive in their mind. She is no more dead. Can you get my points, girls? What the poet is trying to say here? Here he is saying that we should not think as that the person is dead. We have to think the beautiful thing what she was doing in the lifetime. So by remembering, by imagining those things, that beautiful memories will be remain in our mind, and she is no more dead. That is the thing he wants to convey. Is that clear, ma? Okay. Then we'll discuss about some questions, like university question. So please, girls, it can be asked in any way, like critically analyze the theme of the poem or explore the theme of the poem, give a thematic study of the poem, like that. Okay. For that, what you have to write is, first you have to write introduction. That is, in that introduction part, you have to write the poem Bells for John White's Daughter was published in the year 1924. It was published in Ransom's collection of poetry, Chills and Fever. Okay. This poem depicts a tragic situation in an unsentimental way. For him, death is a sorrowful one, but if the loses the parents, imagine the cheerful life of the dead. They can see their dead son or daughter alive in their mind. The young one will be no more dead. Is that clear, ma? Now, the shocked mourner. Bells for John Whiteside's Daughter is a short funeral poem in 5 stanzas. The poet, through the mourner, mirrors the grief of the parents, the acquaintances, and of the entire community over the untimely death of a little girl, untimely death of a young girl. The mourner is shocked and refuses to accept the fact of the death of the girl. They are in shock that they are not accepting the reality. Okay, they are not ready to accept that the little girl was dead. Is it clear? Okay. The language of the first and last stanzas of the poem, as well as the use of the first person plural pronouns throughout the poem, clearly emphasizes the mourner's shock and resentment that such a lively and cheerful little girl has been suddenly taken out of the world. The mourner is almost thunderstruck by the contrast between the active little girl and the brown study into which she has fallen. The meaning of brown study is serious and dead. By the words, the poet clearly contrasts the inactivity of the girl with her previous active life. Is that clear? Who is very high spirit, who is very active, now she is motionless, she is still, she is not moving. Okay. Is that clear, ma? Can you get me? Okay, then. The girl's playful activity. You see, there is the mourner captures the scene of the child who just few days ago was chasing geese with a stick, but today she is in coffin in the room of her wealthy father's home. All the neighbors, including the father, are gathered at the mourner's home, and they are ready to take the girl's body to the burial ground. It is very heartfelt thing, right? The shock and distress of the community is very evident. The mourner's troubled reaction to the abrupt and sudden death of the child intensifies after the remembrance of the little girl's chase after the geese. The mourner seems vexed that such an innocent, charming, amusing child is dead now. Okay, they are not ready to accept the reality. They are in a deep shock. What has happened? Like that. Okay. they are thinking the previous days, okay, some days before and now. Okay, is that clear? Can you get me, girls? Okay, then shock for all. The child's sudden death is not only a shock to the parents but also to the entire community, that is the whole area. Hence, the poet uses the words like, we, us, and our. Okay, he is not separating like girl's parents are like relatives like that. He is telling us like we, us, and our. That is, he is together. He is telling. They are in shock. Like everyone is in shock. Okay, he is not separating one another. Is that clear? He represents the entire community. Indeed, the Mauner is speaking for all of us. Okay, he is speaking for all of us, not only he. Okay, he generalized the shock of the death to all the parents, relatives, acquaintances, and neighbors. Hence, he says, we are vexed. That is, they are upset. We are sternly stopped. That is, in a shock, they are not moving. They stop there. As a parent, a relative, or neighbor, we may feel the anguish of the mourner at the sudden death of a young child. Is that clear? Poem for parents. That is, Ransom writes this poem to the father of the girl. He intends for the girl's parents to read and offer a balanced view of life and death. The balanced view will help them grieve in a positive way. He offers a way to mourn unsentimentally. Okay, they should not see the loss only. They have to remember the pleasant thing, what she has done in those days. Okay, in that way, they will mourn little. Okay. Ransom projects himself an unsentimental father who never laments the death or the loss of the girl's life. Ransom suggests that the girl is dead, but he takes it as the girl is a happy, cheerful child who is lost in play in a world of her own. For a grief-stricken parent, the remembrance of the girl's cheerful day offers a sort of solace. They become bearable with the reality. Is that clear, ma? Okay. Then, conclusion. Thus, Ransom has presented the poem in a responsible way to the parents. He suggests how to develop a matured attitude towards death of a son or a daughter. Can you get me, girls? Okay. Is that clear? We'll see some of the annotations here. Annotation is also very important. So we will see that, like, a common context to all the annotation, that is, you have to read the poetical line and you have to analyze that which line is taken from which poem and which writer. So differentiation you have to know. That is, these lines are extracted from the poem Bells for John Whiteside's Daughter, written by John Crow Ransom. Okay, and after that only you have to write explanation. There was such a speed in her little body, brown study. When the poem begins, there is a corpse of a young girl. The mourner is shocked at the fact of the sudden death. He looks at the dead body of his daughter. The mourner contrasts the young girl with her constant movement in life, with her stillness in death. The girl used to be actively occupied in her work, such as reading, but now she is motionless. She is dead, pale and still. The observers, together with the parent, believe that the girl is in her work and not in death, so she will come back of life again as soon as she completes the work. So, the father believes that she, the dead girl, is in her brown study, referring to a daydream of the girl. Is that clear, ma? Okay, the next lines here also you have to write the context. That is, these lines are extracted from the poem Bells for John White's Daughter, written by John Crow Ranson. After that only you have to write the explanation. Is that clear, ma? Her words were bruited in our high window, are harried unto the pond. Here, the mourner commemorates the playfulness and high spirit of the girl who is dead now. The girl used to see and hear from window while he was about to begin his work. That picture comes to the mourner and he still believes that the girl is around the window. He sees the picture of the girl who, after death, seems to take her arms against her shadow and chase the geese as if they were an army to be conquered. Is that clear, ma? Okay, girls, by this, that is the end of the poem. If you have any doubts, please do ask in the comment box, girls. Surely I'll clarify your doubts. Okay, thank you. Take care. Bye-bye. Allah Hafiz.